It may make you sad to hear it, but this is the last story I'm going to tell you. I know, you like to hear funny stories with jolly people and a happy end, but I don't have the strength for that anymore. What difference would it make if I lied to you? Well, my last story takes place in a land far away, a land that is about to die. It begins in the autumn forest. This is the story of Sadwick, the sorrowful clown. Sadwick is sleeping uneasily, like every night. And he doesn't even know that he'll destroy the world in the course of just a few days.
What a nightmare. Every night it's the same. I can hardly remember the last time I had a decent night's sleep. Spot? Where could Spot be? He usually comes to see me in the morning.
Herzlich willkommen zu den Entwicklerkommentaren von Whispered World. Mein Name ist Marco Höhlen und neben mir steht der Poki.
Hallo, ich bin Poki. Ihr kennt mich aus Entwicklerkommentaren zu, keine Ahnung, das Leben des Gutfried. Ach nee, das ist eine Wurstfirma. Ich habe keine Ahnung. Erzähl du doch zuerst einmal. Ich habe Texte geschrieben bei dem Spiel. Und du?
Ich habe so Bildchen gemalt.
Sehr schön. Und plötzlich war das Spiel fertig. Leider heute nicht mit hier. Hinter dem Mikro ist Bade, also unser Sebastian Schmidt, der sich gedrückt hat, aber tatsächlich auch einen großen Teil der Produktion von The Whisper World mitgehostet hat. Also er ist quasi der dritte Pfeiler im Story- und Rätselteam. Also ein Teil der Rätsel und der Story kommen von Marco, eigentlich der wichtigste Teil, weil er ja derjenige ist, der sich die Whispered World erdacht hat und sich den Charakter Sedwick ausgedacht hat und schon sehr viel gezeichnet hatte, als wir ihn dann hier mit seinem Projekt zu Dedelic geholt haben. Und genau, ich kam dazu und wir haben gesagt so, ja, Spiel war gerade auf dem Stand, wo es, glaube ich, künstlich durch eine andere Firma versucht wurde, wieder ein bisschen kleiner zu machen, und es wäre recht klein geworden und wir wollten eigentlich wieder Markus' komplette Vision auspacken und haben dann festgestellt, dass noch gar kein so richtiger runder Storybogen in der Mitte eigentlich fehlte, weil du hattest ja die dramaturgische Klammer und du hattest den gesamten Anfang und schon einige Ideen, aber eigentlich fehlte noch ein großer Teil. Genau, und dann bin ich dazugekommen und habe versucht, weil ich ja möglichst wenig Einfluss auf Markus' Vision nehmen wollte, halt irgendwie erstmal zu interpretieren, wo du überhaupt hin wolltest, so war es, und bin dann immer zu Marco gekommen und habe ihm gesagt so, ach, das hast du ja bestimmt so und so und so gedacht, und Marco sagt dann immer, nee, das stimmt nicht. Und je öfter das passiert ist, desto frustrierter bin ich geworden, bis hin zur Weißgrund, weil ich immer dachte so, nee, jetzt habe ich es aber, jetzt weiß ich aber, worauf Marco eigentlich hinaus wollte. Bis wir nachher so eine Pufferzone zwischen uns brauchen. Und das war der Bade, der dann halt den dritten Teil des Game Designs und der Geschichte mit beigesteuert hat. Mhm. Ja, und zu dritt haben wir es dann tatsächlich auch hinbekommen, das ganze Spiel zu schreiben und durchzukonzipieren, ohne uns die Kehle aufzuschneiden. Aber es war teilweise nah dran.
Ja, genau, wir waren auf jeden Fall ein Dreier gespannt. Schade, dass er eigentlich jetzt gar nicht hier ist. Hat sich gedrückt,
genau.
Ganz unfair.
Und genau, bei allen Rätseln, die in seinem Spielteil, die er halt alleine gemacht hat, da können wir jetzt über ihn lästern.
Ja.
Und sagen, hier, ich weiß, dass dieses Labyrinth im dritten Kapitel zum Beispiel, also mit den sich drehenden Räumen und so weiter, da können wir richtig auspacken und über ihn lästern dann.
Das Gesicht von ihm, ja. Ja, genau. Das haben wir da auch noch mit reingenommen. Genau. Gut, der erste Raum sollte erstmal ein bisschen gemütlich wirken, sollte Miyazaki oder wie auch immer er heißt, die Ghibli-Studio-Filme ein bisschen erinnern. Ich hatte kurz vorher auch nochmal Chihiros Reise ins Zauberland geguckt. Hat uns sehr beeinflusst dafür. Und wenn ihr genau hinschaut, seht ihr unten links M plus O. Marco, das bin ich. Olga heißt meine Frau. Und solche kleinen Easter Eggs werdet ihr auf jeden Fall öfter nochmal finden.
Irre, das wusste ich gar nicht, Marco. Das ist mir nie aufgefallen.
Siehst du, deshalb sag ich dir das jetzt auch.
Ich habe den ersten Raum hauptsächlich deswegen so unglaublich gut in Erinnerung, weil da so viele Details waren. Wir haben uns entschieden, aus fast allem einen Hotspot zu machen. Und weil wir Sedwick ja noch nicht kannten, ich musste ihn auch beim Schreiben der Texte nachher auch erstmal kennenlernen, weil es stand zwar schon fest, wie er aussieht und was sein Problem mit der Welt ist und so weiter, aber noch nicht, wie er sich gibt und dieses ganze charakteristische Rumnörgeln an der Welt und so weiter, das war noch alles gar nicht etabliert. Und deswegen habe ich hier auch geübt für Sedwick und ganz viele kleine persönliche Details in allen Objekten und so weiter beim Text verstecken können. Was natürlich nur ging, weil der Raum auch so schön detailreich ist. Und ja, später haben wir das natürlich nicht mehr gemacht, dass Sedwick sich alles angucken wollte, weil der Spieler soll ja auch eine gewisse Geschwindigkeit beim Spielen haben. Aber hier am Anfang dachten wir, bremsen wir ihn nochmal ein bisschen aus und lassen ihn sich alles angucken, und deswegen gibt es kleine Anekdötchen zu jedem einzelnen Hut und Wäschestück, was da oben von der Decke hängt, und natürlich auch zu allen anderen Objekten im Raum. Und tatsächlich hatte mir irgendwann Bade mal gesagt, dass etwa ein Drittel des gesamten Textes von The Whispered World auf die ersten drei Räume fallen. Das ist natürlich irre, ja. Aber da habe ich mich auch ausgetobt.
Ja, hast auch sehr gut gemacht. Also, Pookie ist immer ein bisschen zurückhaltend irgendwie. Natürlich hat er Sedwick auch entwickelt. Die Geschichte habe ich ein bisschen dazu geliefert, aber überhaupt der Charakter, wie er jetzt ist, das kommt natürlich von Pookie.
Ja, du willst ja nur die Schuld geben.
Okay, cut. Und er hat es wunderbar gemacht.
It's depressing. I hardly own anything. Everything I have fits into this drawer. I have a deal with Ben. He doesn't spit into my drawer anymore, and I refrain from painting his rubber nose black. There's only that stupid note in there. Ben made me write down all my chores. Pure harassment, if you ask me. Oh. Ah, what the heck. I'd better collect the note anyway. Maybe I'll find a fire somewhere. friend has given me a lot of tedious chores for today. Why did I even bother to get out of bed?
Chadwick! Are you awake? Come here at once! The day's already wasting away!
Right. Another happy day in the colorful world of the circus. Spot! Don't just lie around like that. What's wrong with you?
What do you think's wrong with him?
Maybe he's sick. The plague. Or food poisoning.
Don't talk such nonsense.
Worm fungus? Blue pox? It could be anything.
He's thirsty, Sadwick. That's what happens if you don't carry out your chores properly.
Spot can take it. He's tough.
You've got a lot to learn. Caterpillars don't grow very old. Not if you treat them like this anyway. You'd better get used to the idea.
You're just saying that to annoy me.
I'm serious. You better give him something to drink.
Yeah, whatever, Ben. Come on. Let's go, Spot. We'll get you something to drink. And after that, maybe we can finally do something useful. Come on, Spot. I want to get out of here. Let's take a look around the autumn forest. All right, Spot. Time to have a drink. There you go.
You shouldn't let Spot have too much to drink. He'll get bladder trouble.
Like you, Grandpa?
He already looks rather bloated.
Yeah, like you, Grandpa.
Can you tell me what's wrong with Spot?
I gave him something to drink, like you said.
I hope you didn't give him the water from the laundry tub. Heavens, Sadwick! It's full of starch.
Who cares? Spot seems to be all right. Bruno and Spot get along quite well. Bruno won't eat Spot for dessert, and Spot stopped biting Bruno's toenails. I hope to teach Spot how to open doors, but he just can't reach the handle. In this condition, Spot would make terrific bait. Too bad the trap is much too small for him. No, Spot won't make very good bait. Those fire dragons are much too scared of him. Bruno and Spot get along quite well. Bruno won't eat Spot for dessert, and Spot stopped biting Bruno's toenails. Spot doesn't need a costume. I once had shown him a cape for the Burning Hoop Act. It ended in a near tragedy. Since then, we've been performing without a tent. Spot doesn't need a costume. I once had shown him a cape for the Burning Hoop Act. It ended in a near tragedy. Since then, we've been performing without a tent. That's what Bruno is for. It's still a long time until Spot needs to be buried. He's much tougher than my previous pets. Hi, Ben.
Hi, sleepyhead. How often do I have to tell you? Rehearsals start at sunrise.
It's not my fault. I slept very badly last night.
Slept badly? What's that supposed to mean? Not those nightmares again.
They're not ordinary nightmares. They always feel so real. The earthquake, the craggy rocks.
Good heavens, Sadwick. Now pull yourself together. You're a clown, a jester. An entertainer! You're supposed to make people happy, not depressed.
My nightmares must mean something.
Nonsense. Dreams are for losers. The same with your books and your poems. It's time you got a grip on reality. The serious side of life. Does that ring any bells?
You mean colorful balls and makeup?
Geez, Sadwick. You're a real pain. You need to wake up and be productive.
Can't someone else play the clown?
And what do you want to do instead? Lion taming? Just face it, Sadwick. You're not talented enough for the big acts. You can't juggle. You can't throw. You can't even perform your human cannonball act properly.
I'm just fed up with honking noses and farting sounds. Why can't we provide high-class entertainment instead?
And what would that be?
I'd like to do something intelligent is all.
Listen, we make good money without producing anything. What could possibly be more intelligent?
How about philosophy?
What kind of thing?
What could be more entertaining than getting to grips with the very nature of existence?
Not getting to grips with it? Do you have more of those terrific ideas?
I've written a couple of poems.
Oh, please. Spare me your poems. Believe me, nobody needs your cerebral whining.
I sneak to the mirror in the darkest of night. I stare at my image and just see the clown. The louder he laughs, the harder I fight. Oh, sinister world, full of hardship and frowns.
Well, Sadwick, that's exactly why nobody likes you. If you really must write poems, why not some funny limericks?
Limericks?
There once was a young circus clown who imagined the sky falling down. He imagined so bad that it made him quite sad. On his face, he wore always a frown.
Okay, no poems then. But how about theater?
Theater? Nobody understands those pompous blowhards. Do you know why people love the circus? Because they don't have to think too hard.
Ah, I get it. If somebody is in search of a real knucklehead,
he can come straight to me and
his search is over.
Hey, wait a second.
All right. The theater idea is off, but you're right. A circus is the only worthwhile form of entertainment.
Spare me your sarcasm. Nobody likes that kind of humor. Now, go and practice your burping alphabet.
Okay.
Or the human cannonball act.
Is there anything I can do?
Don't tell me you forgot your chores again. I even wrote them down for you.
Oh, those. That's not what I meant. I'd like to do something more important with my time. Something meaningful. Not this depressing day-to-day routine.
The sooner you do what you're supposed to, the sooner you can... Hey! Don't you roll your eyes like that, young man. Responsibility is still responsibility. Preferably, you start practicing your human cannonball act, or take a good look around the area. Maybe you can find somebody who wants to see our performance.
I'd rather do the latter. When's our next performance?
Who knows? This stretch of land is just as deserted as all the others we recently passed through. People are leaving the land. They fear the end of the world.
See you.
Yep, see you. And don't forget, keep smiling. You're a clown, remember?
Grandpa looks even older than usual today. Hello, Grandpa.
Oh, hello, Ben. You look different. Is that a new hat you're wearing?
I'm not Ben, Grandpa.
I know, Ben. They don't make hats like they used to anymore.
I'm Sadwick.
When I was a little clown, we used to wear real hats with big, firm bubbles.
Sadwick, your grandson.
I could knock out a full-grown ox with my bubbles. I know that poor animal, but that's the way people liked their hats back then. Now, what can I do for you, Ben?
I wish you wouldn't always mistake me for Ben.
I know. The world is a vale of tears when you're young. Everybody's against you. But there are worse things than tight hats and pinching shirt sleeves, you know.
I'm paying close attention to your words of wisdom, like always.
When you're old, there are tight pains and pinching pantaloons, too. And this, my boy, is the most important lesson to take into old age. Loose-fitting pantaloons are the most loyal friends you could ever ask for.
Heavens, did he manage to bring his pantaloons into the conversation again?
I had one of those terrible nightmares again.
There's a cute saying I remember from my boyhood on that very subject. What was it? I forgot.
You mean the old saying, dreams are 10 a penny?
What? That's such nonsense. Dreams are not 10 a penny. I once knew a guy who sold dreams at considerably higher prices. Now that I think of it, that guy might have been me.
Who in the world bought dreams?
No one. Well, that was where the plan fell short. But it was worth a try. There are always fools who spend money on any little nonsense.
Say, Grandpa, you've seen a lot of things in your time, haven't you?
You can say that again. You can ask me whatever you, whatever you can carry.
Do you know anything about nightmares and visions?
I know enough that I can't give a profound opinion about them. Only real oracles can interpret dreams. And they're the only ones that can tell you if it was a vision of some sort. I once thought I had a vision too, you know? Ah, yes, an angel appeared and told me that one day my pantaloons would save the world. I was so excited. I went on pilgrimages, gathered disciples around me, and performed services. And all that without ever changing my pants. Finally, a gypsy told me that it had only been a nightmare. Oh, Ben, you can hardly imagine how embarrassed I was. 5 years in a monastery. Simply because I had chili casserole before bedtime.
What do you know about the autumn forest?
Ah, the autumn forest is it's an enchanted place full of mystery. Strange creatures dwell there, but not as many nowadays as in the past. In ancient times, lots of diverse tribes lived there. Ah, you can still find traces of them in ruins and in caves. When I was a child, half the valley was submerged underwater. Now, there's only that little lake with the island. That's all I can remember at the moment.
That's not surprising. You'd even forget the color of your hair if you didn't look in the mirror regularly.
But I still know that it starts with a G.
That doesn't count. You're just guessing.
But I'm right.
Why? Yes,
See? That's a word. That's all I need to know. Oh, please let it be green.
You know what? I'll just look it up myself.
Yes, yes, yes. Couldn't hurt. I might still seem quite bright in the head. Hey, but sometimes the details get a little mixed up.
See you later.
Cheer up, Ben.
Ich muss ja gerade mal lachen, weil Marco hat mir gerade eben drüber erzählt, dass das Spiel ursprünglich Ich, der Kosmos heißen sollte. Er hat mir noch nicht erzählt, warum. Und er hat gesagt, das erzählt er ganz zum Schluss bei diesem, bei den Entwicklerkommentaren. Das ist ein Fakt, den hatte ich nicht, den wusste ich nicht. Und warum es so ist, das erfahren wir erst ganz zum Schluss, weil er euch natürlich nicht spoilern will.
Nein,
aber
nein.
Ich, der Kosmos, wäre auch ein guter Titel gewesen. Ja.
Wir auf jeden Fall gewesen.
Ja, jetzt sind wir aber bei Oma, bei Opa im Wohnwagen hier.
Genau, der Raum sollte halt typisch Adventure-mäßig werden. Er sollte vollgeknallt sein mit irgendwelchen lustigen, kleinen, witzigen Sachen. Zum Beispiel ein Stein, der einfach Feuer spuckt. Oder ein Frosch, der in einem, der wahrscheinlich schon als kleine Kaulquappe in irgendein Glas reingeschmissen wurde und dann gewachsen ist und dann riesengroß in einer Flasche drin ist. Was haben wir denn da noch alles so? Poki, was siehst du?
Ja, ich sehe natürlich den, den großen Kessel mit der Petroleumsuppe. Und ich sehe gleich unser erstes Arschloch-Rätsel, gleich im dritten Raum. Und zwar, beziehungsweise sehe ich jetzt gerade nicht, weil die Tür ist ja offen. Das wäre nämlich halt einen wichtigen, für alle, die jetzt den Kommentar angeklickt haben, bevor sie hier rätseln, haltet euch mal kurz die Ohren zu. Da hinter der Tür versteckt sich nämlich ein Korken. Riesen Arschloch-Rätsel, dass man die Tür halt erstmal wieder manuell zumachen muss, um dieses Item zu bekommen. Fand ich aber gut. Hervorragend. Und natürlich, besonders Spaß hat es mir gemacht, den Charakter von Opa auszugestalten. Zu Opas Hose werden wir wahrscheinlich noch ganz, ganz viel erzählen. Das hat uns, glaube ich, allen Spaß gemacht. Aber dass Opa auch so ein bisschen mehr Abenteurer ist, als man ihm so optisch zutraut und halt irgendwie mehr erlebt hat und halt irgendwie auch ein bisschen eklig ist. Ganz mit dem tollen Holzgebiss und dem Haarnetz und so weiter. Großartig. Ja, schöner Raum.
Grandpa's hairnet. He always uses it when he doesn't want his hair to get wet. When taking a bath, when he's cooking, and while he's asleep. More recipes. Blood of earthworms. The bottle is almost empty again. Beaver eyes. Grandpa uses them as cooking ingredients. He calls the dish eye candy. Well, who would have thought? Those really are regular recipes. There goes my theory that Grandpa is preparing our meals from the fishing bait manual. Grandpa has always had a soft spot for animals. Raw? Ugh. That's Grandpa's third pair already. The last two were eaten by Woodworm, and it's only a matter of time with these. Well, who would have thought? Those really are regular recipes. There goes my theory that Grandpa is preparing our meals from the fishing bait manual. Grandpa's latest creation, petroleum soup. Inflammatory on the stomach, highly flammable in general, and a hazard to all low-flying birds in the vicinity. Bruno sleeps almost all day. He has to drag our trailers through dark forests during the night. I bet he never has nightmares. On the other hand, maybe this world is his nightmare. Bruno! What a shame. He's asleep. He's the only one in the family who listens to me. Fire dragon trap is empty once again. Grandpa always uses Nawahi eggs as bait. Hey Grandpa, do we have some bait for the fire dragon trap?
Yes, I'm afraid not. I used the last Nawahi eggs for an omelet.
Es ist gerade nur allzu klassisch, gleich im zweiten spielbaren Screen einen weiteren Protagonisten einzuführen. Und so haben wir es auch bei The Whispered World gemacht, dass wir nämlich hier die eigentliche Hauptperson des Spiels eingeführt haben. Ich glaube, sie ist auch auf der Schachtel der Special Edition abgedruckt, oder? Das wissen wir jetzt noch nicht. Ist noch nicht ganz entschieden zu dem jetzigen Zeitpunkt, wo wir es hier gerade aufnehmen. Aber ich glaube, das wird tatsächlich der werden. Der richtige Protagonist des Spiels ist draußen auf der Schachtel. Möglicherweise jetzt drauf, vielleicht auch nicht. Und zwar ist es nämlich natürlich Opas Hose. Die nämlich tatsächlich im Alleingang die Welt retten wird. Also ich muss euch jetzt einfach schon mal spoilern. Also Opas Hose wird nachher tatsächlich noch sehr wichtig, auch für die geplanten 4 Fortsetzungen oder 5 Fortsetzungen von Whispered World.
10.
Achso, und dann ist natürlich auch noch Spot im Bild, der es wahrscheinlich nicht aufs Cover schaffen wird. Nee, also gehe ich mal nicht davon aus.
Wen gibt's denn da noch so? Wir haben noch Bruno. Bruno ist das Zugtier der Wagen, also das Haustier sozusagen eigentlich von der Zirkusfamilie, was mit seinem Schnarchen eigentlich komplett den Raum abdeckt und total nervig ist. Aber wir wollten so.
Ja, vor allen Dingen deswegen, weil Marco musste da halt nur diesen einen hell-olivton zeichnen und den halt als große Fläche und musste dann halt nicht so viel Rasen zeichnen. Marco hat mir mal verraten, dass er es gehasst hat, den Rasen zu zeichnen, weil er so viel Detail reingezeichnet hat. Und er konnte halt einfach die gesamte Fläche hell-olivgrün. Das war's.
Du weißt ja nicht, was ich dahinter gemalt habe.
Das weiß ich sehr wohl, aber ich sag's hier nicht laut, weil es hören ja vielleicht auch Kinder zu.
Ja. Können wir am Ende erzählen.
Ja.
Keep your hands off the laundry. You'll only soil them again.
Unfortunately, Ben is right. Spot really was just thirsty. Come on, Spot. I want to get out of here. Let's take a look around the autumn forest.
Where are you going?
I want to look around the forest.
Don't get lost.
Don't worry. What the?
I could have told you that. You and your sense of orientation.
Water looks downright cloudy. No, wait. That's just a reflection of my face. I'm not thirsty. At least, not enough to drink this. After all, Grandpa's pantaloons have been washed in it. That's Grandpa's shovel. He digs for roots and onions with it. Working in a compost heap, I think he stirs the soup with it, too. No, that's not a spoon. Strange. Where did I even get that idea from? This rock reminds me of one of the most basic principles of life. No matter what you have accomplished, no matter how big your paws or how sharp your teeth are, you can still end up being a doormat for a band of circus clowns. Hello? Are you really dead? Or are you just taking a nap? You can't be sure enough with this kind of thing. This rock reminds me of one of the most basic principles of life. No matter what you have accomplished, no matter how big your paws or how sharp your teeth are, you can still end up being a doormat for a band of circus clowns. Our old stove. The handle is broken off. In order to light a fire, it has to be opened first. Too bad the handle has broken off. Ah, yes. The broken stovepipe. Quite funny how the mind works. Since the handle broke, I made a fuss about how cold it is, forgetting how I always complained about the smoke before. I guess somebody should blow out the soot. Someone who's taller than I am. And not an asthmatic, and who doesn't fear dying from soot poisoning. Somebody other than me, then. What was that note again? Ah, yes. I remember now. It's where Ben sketched out how the human cannibal act is supposed to work. It's so unfair. He can even draw better than me. That's supposed to be me. Ben didn't get the fearful expression on my face right, though. The most important thing is a solid barrel for the cannon. After all, the cannoneer shouldn't be harmed when he blows me sky high. The plug is attached to the mouth of the barrel. It's the only way to get enough pressure to blow me hundreds of yards into the air. Oh boy, how I hate this act.
Ja, der Kanonenrohrtrick.
Der Kanonenrohrtrick.
Ja. es war, ich sag mal, es war eine Herausforderung. Ein paar von den Rätseln, die Marco sich hat einfallen lassen für den ersten Teil, die halt auch schon alle im Hintergrund irgendwie gezeichnet worden waren und so weiter, und die einfach nicht mehr rauszuoperieren waren, hat tatsächlich tatsächlich mit der Geschichte um Sedgwick zu verbinden und der Kanonenrohrtrick, also das war tatsächlich möglicherweise die größte Herausforderung.
Es war ein wenig bescheuert, das will ich jetzt nicht sagen, aber ja.
Nee, aber im Endeffekt hat es sehr stark geholfen. Alleine, wie sich Sedgwick diesen Zettel anguckt und halt irgendwie und nochmal zu verstehen, wie sehr er sein Leben hasst und wie sehr er diesen Kanonenrohrtrick hasst, hat einem dann schon im Endeffekt Spaß gemacht. Also den Spaß hat irgendwie angefacht, ja. Wie er nachher im Kapitel...
An dem Screen war halt ganz schön irgendwie, jeder hat drauf geguckt und dachte, oh Gott, das geht doch nie, das ist doch blöd und so weiter. Bis dann irgendwie die Pokisprüche mal drauf kamen. Die schönen Dialoge und die haben das dann halt gewürzt, dass man sich irgendwie doch vorstellen konnte. Das war halt schon echt sehr schön. Doch, komm.
Mit dem Pfropf, man braucht einen Pfropf.
Natürlich braucht man einen Pfropf, sonst ist doch der Druck nicht so drauf.
Ja, für einen Kanonenrohrtrick braucht man einen Pfropfen. Alter.
A parachute should provide a safe landing. Then there's nothing to worry about, is there? A A small bomb or some gunpowder are sufficient. Just load the cannon and light the fuse. Everything else will turn out fine. Seriously, that's what it says. Everything else will turn out fine. I can't believe this is real.
Yes?
Did you put that note up here?
Yeah, I wrote down the instructions for your human cannonball act.
My human cannonball act?
Sure. You must be able to do something useful, right? And Grandpa is getting too old for that kind of thing.
Ben must have put it up there for a reason. Probably as a reminder that I'm not capable of doing anything right without his help. Marbles, ruffs, small bells. I'd be less embarrassed wearing a potato sack. Our circus costumes are spittle repellent. That's quite important, especially when you play the bigger towns. I can't reach it. That's too bad. That's Ben's spare hat. He doesn't like to wear it quite as much as he used to. He says it sags too much since I spilled all the starch. Our circus costumes are spittle repellent. That's quite important, especially when you play the bigger towns. I can't reach it. Ben doesn't like me to wear his hats. He says they always sag so pitifully afterwards. I once made a list of the most probable causes of my death. The bear's paw was listed number 212, 217, and 321 to 329. That's no use. The handle is broken off. Ben told me this kind of candle burns indefinitely. I'll say it's just pretending. Small flame of hope, for what noble cause do you fight so courageously? And yet, eventually, finally, terminally, even you will extinguish. Ouch! What? Damn, this is going to blister. Why do I have to be so clumsy? Empty, much like everything else I own. Dozen poorly assembled boards hanging from two loosely attached hinges. They protect me from wild predators, murderers, and all the other dangers in life. Or such is the illusion. Ben? Is that you out there?
Is it me out here? I don't believe him. Sitting in the trailer all day long, asking me if it's me out here. Don't you have chores to tend to?
All right, I'm coming.
Can you tell me what's wrong with Spot?
I gave him something to drink, like you said.
I hope you didn't. Heavens, Sadwick!
Who cares? Hello, Grandpa.
Ah, hello, Ben. Is your hat still too tight?
I want you to take a look around the autumn forest, but I keep getting lost.
If you want to go for a walk, have you given Spot something to drink yet?
Yes, Grandpa. All done and finished.
Well, you've earned a little walk then. Ah, but be careful. The autumn forest is big and dense. Yeah, very, very much like my beard. You can very easily get lost in it. Again, very much like my beard.
I already noticed that.
You'd better take my comb. I mean compass with you. Now where did I put it? I know, it's in the trailer. Under the bed.
Great. Thanks, Grandpa. Under the bed, right?
Yes, under the bed. I like to take a pinch late at night.
Take a pinch of the compass?
Yes, I know, it's unhealthy. But at my age, well...
Are you sure you're talking about the compass? Don't you mean compote?
Compote? What are you insinuating? Did you nose around my notes? Besides, if I planned anything like that, it would be none of your business. You must consider all the consequences of such a compote, you know.
A compote with broad ramifications?
Yes, so you'd better keep your nose out of it.
Oh, Grandpa, you're talking about a complot. You're planning a complot.
A complot? I have no idea what you're talking about. You don't need to plan a complot. I just made one not 10 minutes ago, right behind the trailer.
That's compost.
Impossible. I carry the compost with me all the time.
The compost?
It's in my pocket. I'm pretty sure it is. Just a second. Here it is.
Grandpa, that's not compost. That's the compass.
Really? Then where's the compost? Would you mind checking under my bed?
Sure. Just remind me again later, okay? Now, I'm taking a walk in the autumn forest.
I'd be back for lunch, you hear?
No, thanks. I really don't care for petroleum soup.
What's that?
Oh, nothing really. Thanks, Grandpa. See you later.
Cheer up, Ben.
What the?
Yeah, that's like playing blind man's bluff without a blindfold.
Compass needle points north. It's all quiet, dull, and monotonous there. Must be great. The compass needle points north, where people still know how to keep quiet. Must be great. They say you'll have nightmares if you lie down aligned with the Earth's magnetic field. But that's not the problem with me. I get nightmares no matter which way I lie down. They say you'll have nightmares if you lie down aligned with the Earth's magnetic field. But that's not the problem with me. I get nightmares no matter which way I lie down. Thanks for the compass, Grandpa.
Compass? No, not at this time of day.
Bruno can find his way without map and compass. Even our draft animal is more skilled than I am. That's not suitable for attracting fire dragons. Grandpa always uses Nawaii eggs as bait. What the?
That's getting more and more fun each time.
I got Grandpa's old compass.
With your sense of orientation, it still won't be much help. Maybe you should tie yourself to the trailer so that you won't get lost.
It'd all be happy if I got lost.
Oh, yeah.
The compass needle points north. There are caterpillars there that grow 6 feet long. Compass needle points north, where people use waterproof compasses.
Keep your hands off the laundry. You'll only soil them again.
Grandpa uses the shovel to dig ingredients from the compost heap. I'm not putting those in my mouth. They're neither my size nor my taste. I'd rather leave him in there. It wouldn't be much fun to suck it through with a bottleneck for either of us. Yeah. That would look hilarious. Too bad I can't squeeze it through the bottleneck. Well, who would have thought? Those really are regular recipes. There goes my theory that Grandpa is preparing our meals from the fishing bait manual. Yuck. I'm sorry, but I won't put that into my mouth. Not when there's the slightest possibility that Grandpa blew his nose on it. Yuck. The door is rotten and loose-fitting. It's pretty chilly during the night. It's a miracle that Grandpa hasn't died of pneumonia. We have much in common. This bottle is corked, and I'm screwed up. Unreachable, like so many things. Cooking is one of Grandpa's tasks, not mine. Not that I didn't offer to cook, but Ben objected. It's a sign of how low his esteem for me is. I mean, petroleum soup? Seriously. Ouch! Hot. Cooking is one of Grandpa's tasks, not mine. Not that I didn't offer to cook, but Ben objected. It's a sign of how low his esteem for me is. I mean, petroleum soup? Seriously. To blow Bruno's nose would be a lifetime effort. Can I borrow your handkerchief, Grandpa?
Of course, my boy. Be my guest. When I was young, I always had a runny nose, too.
Are you collecting useless junk again? Oh, stop bothering me with it. You can see that I have my hands full.
That's wet already.
Ugh.
Keep your hands off the laundry. You'll only soil them again.
Do you need your dentures, Grandpa?
No, not really. We're having soup today. They'd just be in the way.
I'd better not show it to him. Grandpa gets really mad when somebody pulls the corks from his bottles. Like on the day when I opened a bottle labeled spirits. I should have known it didn't refer to the alcohol.
Thank you.
Unfortunately, Ben is right. Spot really was just thirsty. Come on, Spot. I want to get out of here. Let's take a look around the autumn forest. Grandpa's hairnet. He always uses it when he doesn't want his hair to get wet, when taking a bath, when he's cooking, and while he's asleep. Do you need a hairnet, Grandpa?
Only when I'm cooking, sleeping, or bathing. In other words, just when my hair needs to stay dry.
Hey, Grandpa, do we have some bait for the fire dragon trap?
I'm afraid not. I used the last Noahi eggs for an omelet.
That's my brother, Ben. I'll never be able to juggle as good as him. And he keeps telling me that. Over and over again. When will I get my own trailer?
Oh, that's a good one. You should be pleased you don't have to share a toothbrush with Grandpa anymore.
Can I try?
You want to juggle? You'd drop your nose if it wasn't attached to your face. Juggling is something for men of action, not for brooding types like you.
What the?
That's getting more and more fun each time.
He's had enough already.
You shouldn't let Spot have too much to drink. He'll get bladder trouble.
Like you, Grandpa?
He already looks rather bloated.
Yeah, like you, Grandpa. Unfortunately, Ben is right. Spot really was just thirsty.